I mean, I'll tell you. It's a boat, it's a boat. So actually just now Plastic said I made a boat. And then now she made a boat. So so since she made a boat, so I look at what she did just now. She did a cake. So I get new inspiration from her. So from her cake, then I thought so these are the very basic things in life which we sometimes take for granted. But maybe that is the most important thing in life, which is just like what we're doing. So,
okay. Yeah, but it's interesting how you evolve. Initially, I want to do a cut. Then do a cylindrical shape. So I try to roll, 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 pancake, roll, right? Then try to make it into a cylindrical shape. Basically, it don't look like a cylinder, it looks very terrible. It don't look good. Okay? So in the end I said, okay, never mind, just do a trophy. Okay, so I can't do a trophy. Then I said, okay, but trophy doesn't mean that I want to do a trophy in my life. Okay? So I said I wanted to see things that spring up in my life. Okay, and I tried to draw a tree.
Okay.
So the tree, I tried to roll, cannot find the branches. It's so hard to make branches. So I said, okay, never mind. I just try to clean the tree. That means like, we don't just do a trophy in our life. I just mean like, the tree will continue to grow. So it represents knowledge, it represents continual growth. So I show the branches, I said, no, the branches doesn't help.
Maybe we have a thank you for sharing, right, and taking this session with you back. Last thing for the day, right, the last session for the day. I have two options. Initially, I thought of maybe you can to end it off, find a buddy, somebody that you know here, right, and share with the person any high point that you have in your life. Any exhilarating moment or something that you have done and you are so proud of yourself. Look through flashback of your memories since you are young now. Anything that you have done and you think that you have done just right or something that you are proud of, and share with your friend or this newfound friend.
I have an interesting story that I would like to share with you. Some of you have heard this story before, some of you have not heard this story before. Okay, why I share with you this story? Because this story is an open-ended story. The good thing about open-ended story is you can come out with your conclusion. I always like children, because some of the children are very open-ended. Then you come out with your own conclusion. So I'll tell you this story. Hopefully this story will have some impact on you, where you are, what you are doing, your passion, about your job, or the situation of life that you are in now. So after this story, I would like you to make object. At the end of the story, make an object. What is the object? Only you know. Okay? So how many of you have actually heard this story before? For the music piece? Okay, so some of you have heard it before. Some of you haven't. So it's a very interesting story. I guarantee you, you will learn some, you will get some thinking from the end of the story. And again, because just now you were mentioning about going through the journey and seek for the vegetables and whatever nutrients and over the mountain, over the sea kind, right? Suddenly, I was like, wow, this is perfect. Because this story is about seeking the vegetables, right? And whatever nutrients that you want in your life, over the mountain, over the sea. Okay? So, why am I using this one? Okay, this is about active reviewing, right? So active reviewing, you can use different tools to engage the participants or the students to open up different perspectives. Right, just now, we talk about individual, we talk about team, we talk about making together. I was toying between playing a song. You listen to the music and to the song. At the end of the song, you make something out of it. And or tell a story. Okay, end a story, you make something out of it. So I choose the story part. Okay, so if you want, you can use that to a different reason in the song. Okay, so can I share the story? Can you see the book? Because you need to see the picture, it's a pictorial story, right? Story telling session. Okay, the title of this story is called The Missing Piece by Shields Everston. Shields Everston. See, this guy actually wrote quite a fair bit of books. So after this book, there are a continuation part of this story. Right, but this is part one of the story. If you're interested, I have another, this is a part two of this story. Okay, so this is the story. He was missing a piece and he was not happy. So you can look at your plasticine or something like that. It's not perfect. Because he's missing a piece and he's not happy. So he set off in search for his missing piece. So as he rolled along, he sang this song. Oh, I'm looking for my missing piece. I'm looking for my missing piece. I behold, here I go, looking for my missing piece. So his sole purpose in life is to look for the missing piece. Sometimes he gets baked in the sun. But then the rain will fall down. And sometimes it was frozen by the snow. But then the sun will come and warm it again. And because he was missing a piece, he cannot go very fast. So sometimes he will stop by and talk to a worm. Or smell a flower. And sometimes he will pass a beetle. And sometimes the beetle will pass it. And this was the best moment of all. Because it was not very fast. So the butterfly could land on his feet. Okay? And on he went. Over oceans, overseas, okay? And still singing the song. Oh, I'm looking for my missing piece. Over land and overseas. So beast by beast and beast by beast. I'm looking for my missing piece. He went through the swamps and the jungles. Up the mountain. Down the mountain. Until one day, lo and behold, I have found my missing piece, he says. I have found my missing piece. So piece by piece and piece by piece, I have found mine. Wait a minute, say the piece. Before you go on piecing your piece and piecing your piece, I am not your missing piece. I am nobody's piece. I am my own piece. And even if I was somebody's missing piece, I don't think I'm yours. Oh, he said very sadly. I'm so sorry that I have bothered you. So he go away. And then he found another piece. Not another piece, huh? But this one was too small. And I'll keep it. And this one was too big. And this one was too sharp.